All right, we're about to get into it. How do you make a lot of money in a bad economy? This is for the folks who are here to learn how to make money. This is for the folks who are ready and primed to make money. And for all of you investor folks, you can eat a bag of penises. I don't really care. But anyway, how does one make a lot of money in a bad economy? The first thing is to sell what people are looking for. And this is gonna come back to needs, and this is gonna come back to things they require. Recently, I went out shopping for a new bike. All of the bike stores are out of bikes. Now, why is this? During this pandemic, people's mores have changed. They're doing more simple things. Bike sales have exploded, RV sales have exploded, home sales have exploded, and we'll talk about why home sales exploded and why I expect home sales to crash. Home sales exploded because during the pandemic, many people realized that living in an apartment kind of sucked, and they wanted more room and more space to live their lives. So this is why home sales are exploding. However, part of the reason that home sales are exploding is a lot of people with homes they wanted to sell due to the pandemic are not putting them on the market. So there's a limited inventory, which pushes the price points up. That's not going to continue. Once the natural market forces start to play, because look at the number of people who took the mortgage company's offers of forbearance. If that didn't happen, there would not be a low inventory. There would be amazing, crazy inventory. So you have to look at what's going on in the marketplace. And with real estate is local. There are certain areas of real estate that are sucking wind right now. And there are certain areas of real estate that are exploding. Like during the 2009 recession, there wasn't a recession in Houston. So real estate prices and rental markets were firm. So you gotta do your research when you're getting in real estate, because you gotta know what's going on with your market. In any event, you've gotta do your research, period. If you wanna make a lot of money during a bad economy, you should be positioned. This is one of the biggest issues that so many business owners have: undercapitalization. When times are good and you're making money, you should be putting money in a war chest. And many business owners don't do this. So when times flip, and then they start running into revenue shortfalls, and this has put them in the position where sometimes they have to go out of business because they don't have enough money to keep going. So when times are good, you need to stash cash. You need to leave money in your corporation, because there's so many people. Like, I love Grant Cardone, but some of the stuff he doesn't break down into the details, because Grant Cardone doesn't practice this stuff. He's like, every time I get some money, I spend it. That's not true. He's got a war chest, a personal war chest of several million dollars that he has in reserve. So he's not exactly being honest with the people. Because if you take every penny and you invest it, right, and you have no cash reserves, this is going to come to a point where it's going to bite you in the butt. It's going to come. It's going to happen, because markets shift, markets change. So one of the things as a business owner is you need to prepare for these bad times, because if you have cash during bad times, you are king, and you will be able to get anything with cash. Your dollars are just going to go further. So that's pre-positioning, because like in 2017, 18, 19, I told you guys this recession was coming, and a lot of folks listened, and a lot of folks prepared, and a lot of folks saved money. A lot of folks didn't listen, and they're in trouble today. So let's talk about the most important thing: marketplaces and audiences. What marketplaces are exploding right now? Right now, Amazon, eBay, Etsy, anybody that already had a strong e-commerce presence, they're making money like it's Christmas. There are many of my friends that I've talked to who have e-com stores that were positioned for the pandemic, before the bad times, and they have cash reserves. And this is something they all do. They kept advertising, because this is something you got to do. Many people during bad times cut their marketing budget. That is a mistake. You need to advertise harder and more, because so many people will cut their budgets, advertising gets cheaper. So that's something else that you need to do. So you need to know the marketplace, what marketplace is like. I knew that RV sales were exploding, but that kind of caught me by surprise that they literally ran out of bicycles. And then once I started to think, well, people are at home, people want to be healthy, the gyms are closed, people are going to buy a bike to stay fit. And once I started to think about it, it's like it made sense because people are buying stuff that they need. Something else that is exploding, people who are selling used fitness equipment are making money hand over fist. So you have to look at, during these bad times, what's going on? Because here's the thing, regardless of how bad it gets, there's always going to be a segment of the population that's going to have money. So you need to match up your offering, your services to that group of people that still has money. You know, it's funny because I was sitting there this weekend watching college football and watching the NFL, and I have a feeling, pandemic, no pandemic, that those stands will be full before the end of the season. Because I was watching one game and the stadium was half full, and each game I watch, there are more and more and more people. And people have just decided, I'm gonna live my life, you know. And also look at Trump. Trump has it. Trump's about to go back on the campaign trail. So I figured that they've worked out some better protocols, some better treatments for this, because Trump is like 74 years old. And this is the demographic that this thing's been taking out. But anywho, once again, you have to concentrate on demographic, marketplaces, and what people are selling. Let's talk about something a little spicy. OnlyFans. Demon Time is this guy who started these strip shows on Instagram. He had them on his page. He would have these girls. I don't do Instagram live, so I don't know how it works, but they would sign into his account. They would strip and they were getting tens of thousands of dollars, and to the point Instagram banned them. Then he went to OnlyFans. I don't know how that's working out, but OnlyFans has exploded. You've got girls posting on Instagram with brand new Rolls Royce SUVs. That's a $300,000 SUV. So you got to look at the marketplace. You got to look at what's going on. And once again, marketplaces go up, marketplaces come down. If you don't have a good core business that's in line with the demand, be very, very careful, because if you hop on a trend, because, you know, OnlyFans, that's a trend. It's not going to be like that forever. And it's like right now, people are making a lot of money. And at some point, it's going to settle down, because one of the big issues with OnlyFans is supply. At some point, the supply is going to outstrip the demand. I think we're moving there, because like I said, I'm not into OnlyFans. I don't watch any of that stuff, so I don't really know what's going on with that. But I do know from the anecdotal reports that it literally exploded during the pandemic. And this is something else. Drug use exploded during the pandemic. Alcohol sales exploded during the pandemic. So vices and things that, which is always present, typically go up when times are bad, because people are stressed and they need something to ease their minds. They need something to take some of the stress off. But there are so many ways that you can make a lot of money during bad times. And it starts with positioning. It starts where you position. It starts with capitalization. It starts with marketing. And it starts with running your business. Like, look at me. When this whole thing started, you can go back, you can see documented evidence, I pushed harder on my business. As a result, with the launch of the Corporate Toolbox, it is the biggest launch that I've ever had, and I'm not using paid traffic. Now, for those of you who are not in my world, who don't understand, paid traffic is very powerful because it can create a predictable revenue model. When I tell my friends what I made just using a YouTube channel with no paid traffic, they're like, wow, that's pretty impressive, because they know what these numbers are and what happens. But this is what happened. These are bad times. And I've made more money from the launch of the Corporate Toolbox than I have ever made from launching anything. But look at my behavior. I did not submit. I did not stop working. I did not go, oh, you know, we got a pandemic. You know, you can't. No, I was like, focus, go forward, keep pushing, keep pushing, keep pushing, keep pushing. That's one of the ways that you can make a lot of money during bad times. Keep pushing. Keep advertising, keep marketing. There's going to be so many people, because it's going to get so bad that they're just simply going to give up. They're simply not going to participate. They're going to pull back. So once again, I'm not going to underestimate the position of being well capitalized. And this is something that I need to talk about. You have many business owners who have a really good service, have a good product, but they are undercapitalized or they're not using their money that comes in properly. So if you have a business, especially the first few years, you should take 10%, maybe 25%, depending on what you're making. Let's say you have a business that does $500,000 the first year. You should take 10% out the business to live on and pay your taxes and leave the rest of that money in the business. Now, why is that? Because this is going to position you in a position where your business will always have capital to grow. You know, I know spending money is fun, it's cool, but as a beginning entrepreneur, you need to have a proper money management system in place to ensure that your business keeps going. So one of the things that I want you to understand, and one of the things I want you to know, is having the proper business money management system is so important because it is going to create harmony for your business going forward. Because right now, this is an excellent time to start a business. If you have money, if you have the right idea, if you have the right system, this is a great time to start a business because so many people are leaving the marketplace. So many businesses are going out of business. There's always a number of people who have money. And if you serve those people, you will make money. You will do well. And good times, bad times, because I started this YouTube channel in the height of the 2009 recession, and I made money my first year, I made money my second year, I made a tremendous amount of money my third year. So you got to keep working, you got to keep marketing, you got to keep pushing, but you can make a lot of money during bad times if your head is on correctly and you don't buy into the woe is me, well, we can't do this, we can't do X, Y, and Z. So if you want to increase your chances of making more money, I want you to go below. I have a special in October. I've added the YouTube course. I've added the ads course. There's nothing there in the ads course yet. They will be coming. So you can go ahead and get in for $150 a month for 30 months, or you can pay $3,500. And in November, because the corporate toolbox will be more valuable, the price is going to go up. And no, there will not be a Black Friday sale or a Christmas special, because I know there's some people like, hey, there's going to be a... No, there's not, because I'm going to be adding high-level C-suite content and training to the course for the rest of the year in the beginning of 2021. So there will not be any sales for those of you who are like, come on, man, I'm waiting for the Christmas sale. I'm waiting for the 50% off discount. It ain't happening. So your best time to get in is now, because the price is only going to get more expensive.